รายการต่อไปนี้เป็นรายการทั่วไปสามารถรับชมได้ทุกวัยรับชมเถอะค่ะจะได้ทำข้อสอบได
้ Hi guys welcome to my channel you are here with me Ajarn Nat first of all before we begin I have to say sorry because in this video clip there are some technical problems with my laptop so you might not be able to see me in this video clip butDon't worry, the lesson that we're going to study today is really fun, so let's get started! In this week, we're going to study Componential Analysis and Semantic Features. Before we start, let's have a look at this sentence first. The first sentence is, the hamburger ate the boy. What do you think about the meaning of this sentence?It's quite unreal, right? Because the hamburger is food, it cannot eat people. The only context that this sentence can appear is on the fantasy novel, maybe? Or let's consider other sentences like the table sings happily, my cat was studying linguistics, or the tissue paper was listening to some music. You might notice that these sentences are all syntactically correct, that is to sayThey are all grammatical, but if we look at the meaning of them, these sentences are all semantically odd, which means the meaning is weird, it makes no sense. Why do these make no sense for us? Maybe because the meaning of the words do not align to each other. From this problem, it leads us to think that what kind of analysis that can help us to identify the components of conceptual meanings of words? When we talk about the component of conceptual meaning of words,We refer to the basic meaning that the word literally conveys or refers to. So the way we can analyze the component of conceptual meaning is componential analysis. So simply say that componential analysis is a way to analyze the word meaning. The approach is based upon the belief that the meaning of a word can be categorized into meaning components that is called semantic features. For example, the word hamburgercan have a semantic feature of food, which is a component of conceptual meaning of the word hamburger. Or, as in your book, the word boy can have the feature of animate and human. So, then we can use componential analysis to describe part of the meaning of words. If that word have a particular feature, we mark it by using plus. But if that word do not contain that particular feature, we mark it by usingminus. So, as in your book, the word hamburger doesn't contain the feature of animate, human, and female or adult. That's why we mark it by using minus here. But the word boy, man, girl, woman contain the feature of animate. That's why we mark it by using plus here. From doing the feature analysis like this, it helps us to group the word that has the basic feature together in order to be used in the sentence to avoid the odd or strange meaning. For example, in the case of the sentence, the boy ate the hamburger,If we look at the word ate here, the word that can be the subject of the word ate should be the word that contains semantic feature of being animate. Because in order to do the action of eating, you have to be animated. Non-animate cannot do the action of eating, right? This is the reason why the sentence, the hamburger ate the boy, sounds strange to us.Because the word hamburger doesn't contain the semantic features of being animate. That's why it's not suitable with the word ate here. Plus, from analyzing the semantic feature, we can predict which noun will affect the sentence to be strange and which noun won't. For example, in the same sentence, the dot 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 ate the hamburger, so the word that should be added here in order to prevent the odd meaning should denote animate semantic features. So we can add the word boy or the word man.Or the word girl here, but it cannot be the word table here because the word table doesn't contain the required semantic feature, which is being animate. Because the word table doesn't contain the required semantic feature, which is being animate. More example of analyzing the semantic features by using the componential analysis. The word sushi, gyoza, kimchi soup, bulgogi, pizza, and carbonara, if we analyze the semantic features of these words,The first feature that comes up to our mind could be food. So every word here share the same semantic feature, which is food. Then we denote it by using plus. However, if we take a deep look, these words have some different feature as well. Because they are different by nationality, So, sushi and gyoza share the same nationality, which is Japanese food, but they belong to different semantic features with kimchi soup and bulgogi, which is Korean food. Also, we have another semantic feature, which is Italian food for pizza and carbonara. To sum up, these words have both shared feature and different features, so they can be used differently in the context that require different semantic features. Another example, Gourmet Market, Tops, Bandu Market, Fatai Market. If we analyze the semantic feature of these words, we might get the semantic feature that these words share together is market. But some might think that we can also differentiate the semantic feature of these words as well, which are in the department store and local. So, Gourmet Market and Tops are normally located in the department store, that's why we have plus for them. But Bandu and Fatai are local market, that's why we have plus for them in the semantic feature of local. The last example, Mercedes-Benz S-Class, Audi, Charco, Toyota, Nissan, and Honda. The shared semantic feature of these words could be car, so we mark plus for all words here. But they also have different semantic features as well, because Mercedes-Benz S-Class, Audi, Charco contain the semantic feature of luxury car, whereas Toyota, Nissan, Honda contain the semantic feature of affordable car. So that's all for this chapter. I hope you guys enjoy and understand everything. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below the post. So, see you in a next video clip. Bye!